guys, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. So today I'm gonna talk to you guys about this impeachment process that is somehow catching up my attention, you know, into the details, guys. So as you guys know, you know, I'm a Republican. No need for you to change the channel. At least hear me out and make your own decisions, guys. You know, just give me a couple minutes of your life. Promise I won't waste your time. So if you are aware of what's going on right now on Washington DC, you know, this impeachment process started because President Trump called the guy from the Ukraine, you know, and then it was also some quid pro quo. So on those premises, you know, all this time I'm being like, you know what, because I really work, I work, you know. What, 10 hours out of my day, and then when I get home, I game, I take care of my family, you know. Yeah, I'm a human just like you, you know. Normal person just like you. So I don't have that much time to like listen to the radio or pay attention in depth to what's going on. But for the last couple of days, I've been doing it because I found myself with some free time, you know. listen to the news, read a couple articles, you know, X, Y, and Z. And then I came to realize that this impeachment, today's is, what is today? Today is the 12th of November. I'm sorry, December 2019. I don't know which day I'm living. That's how busy I am. And then on this impeachment, there's nothing about collusion with the FBI, you know, with Russia. There's nothing about the Ukraine. And then the reason why, and then I'm gonna talk to you like a reasonable person, is because they cannot prove it, because they don't have any proof. And that's alarming. What is the impeachment about? They impeach him, they're trying to impeach Trump because of abuse of power and because obstruction of Congress. I mean, so they have spent all this time, which translates to money and witnesses who have witnessed nothing but their own belief and their own what they want, what they believe, what they think. They brought some Ivy League scholars, you know, people that lives in, you know what I mean, you know. There was a joke about, I don't know. And it's very sad to me that you know, after all this money that I spent, your money, my money, our money, taxpayers' money, they cannot come with something. Because I understand that, you know, Trump is my president. You know, I support him. I support any president. That's it. That's it. About there, you know, because, you know, my belief is that it's the majority of the people, based on the electoral college, you know, elect a president. You know, I should support him because, you know, people from all over the country want him or her as president. And it's very sad, guys. It's very sad that, you know that there's nothing. They don't have anything. They don't have anything. I think that the Senate is it's full of Democrats, and they're probably going to impeach him. Even though, as of right now, as we're sitting right now, there's what, six Democrats who are swinging and not voting impeach. They don't feel good about what's going on. I mean, they know. It's like a rigged game, you know, where you go play bingo, and the girlfriend who plays bingo, who calls the bingo numbers, gets the freaking prize all the time. It's ridiculous, you know. But at the same time, it's sad, guys. It's sad because they weren't able to prove that Trump rigged the election, you know. And I told many people, if Trump rigged the election and they have proof, you know, like when you go to court, they got proof and they put you in jail. If they got proof, I don't want him as a president, but they don't have any, you know. If no, they were impeached. They will be impeaching him for that. If that's true about the quid pro quo with Ukraine, hey, let me know, you know, because, you know, I'm changing my mind. But there's no proof, just bunch of opinions, based on a bunch of Democrats, you know, majority Democrats. So I'm coming to the conclusion that, we're gonna have to support the president and back him up, because it's clearly a witch hunt what's going on right now. I don't think that is fair that they just want to impeach the guy because he's just Republican, and because he don't want to bend to the will of this long lifetime politicians who spend their lives in Congress for 20, 30, 40 years, you know? I mean, doing nothing for the country, you know? I go to the VA, and you know what some people tell me? Hey, we're lucky that we have these services right here, but my wife, my daughters, my kids, they don't have the same services. They don't have the same X, Y, and Z. And medication is still expensive as fuck. What they're doing for medical reform, you know? What they're doing to help Hispanic and blacks, what they're doing to his minorities, you know? They're doing shit, man. Donald Trump just passed. Don't vote for somebody, you know, just because you don't want Trump to be elected. Don't vote for somebody who will not represent you well. Don't vote for somebody who doesn't have the best interest, your best interest on the table, okay? Vote for somebody who's gonna put works, jobs in America. Vote for somebody who's gonna keep unemployment down. Vote for somebody who is gonna be able to go to NATO and people are gonna be talking shit about him behind his back. You know why is that? We've been through that. We've been through that. Most of us, we've been through that, where you're not likable, you know? And they don't like you because you think different. They don't like you because somehow your ideas are bigger than theirs. They don't like you because your way of thinking is just way above those people. But guess what? They're not gonna say nothing in front of you. We've been there. We've been there. I mean, this is the main point of today's video, you know? I saw that video, the NATO video, those guys talking shit about Trump, you know? But if they were talking shit about Trump, they were talking shit about America too, you know? Is that easy, guys? Is that easy? And guess what? If you laugh about it, if you say Trump deserves that, all I'm gonna say to you guys is I am very, very honest, and then I have a good memory. I remember when Trump used to go to the Oprah Winfrey? Yeah, show, WWE, you know, Saturday Night Live, you know, the Howard Stern show, all these different things, and everybody loved Trump. Miss Universe, wow, Donald Trump. Everybody put Donald Trump on their music, you know? But now, it's different. Now, out of nowhere, nobody likes Trump. It's like, no, not Trump today, not today. He's Republican. Guys, just like he said, just like Donald Trump himself said, what you have to lose? What you have to lose? You know, when Trump took America, America was doing pretty bad. I think now we're doing pretty good. So what you have to lose to continue trusting somebody who's stuck in America, who is taking America to a better place? Anyway, I'm almost at my office. So have a good day, guys. God bless you, okay? And God bless the USA. Bye.